I've dropped into gorgeous Lausanne, Switzerland to visit EPFL to check out the crash-happy Gimball.
This robot is inspired from insects because we looked at, you know, how flies collide into things, and you know, they do not die when they touch a window. And we wanted to replicate this behavior in a flying robot, because we thought, you know, 500 million years of evolution can be wrong. Gimball is a novel flying robot because it has this rotating protective frame around its inner part with the where the actual flying robot is actually is located, and this allows this robot to collide into things and continue its flight undisturbed. It is also safe to fly close to human because you can touch it in flight. You have this cage protecting the dangerous propellers from you know, hurting your hands. We believe that having this mechanical intelligence built into the system, instead of having, you know, complex obstacle avoidance system, is a great solution to this very complex problem of flying robots indoors.
Can you describe the different components to it?
Sure.
So when I look at it, I see a lot of quadcopters, and I'm like, this is not a quadcopter.
As you said, it's not a quadcopter. It's two contra-rotative propellers. So the idea is to, you know, best use the space inside the sphere, and that's why we use this technology instead of a quad. We have some flaps down there that are used for guidance of the robots and for the stabilization. On board, we have an HD camera. And we have all the electronics that allow for the control of the robot. Now, the real innovation in there lies on this gimbal system. So you can see here two carbon fiber rings that actually decouple the inner frame from the outer frame. So let me just show you the stabilization, you know? So we have lots of different needs. We definitely want to do some search and rescue with this robot. This is really one of the applications that is driving us a lot. But as a first target, we think industrial inspection or things like law enforcement application, firefighting, and also, you know, simply consumer goods. We can think of a robot that can be a very fun tool or game inside houses.
What struck me most about Gimball was how at ease I was with it, flying around me and even into me. I can see people being totally comfortable and even entertained by these types of robots right up in their faces. Just don't forget about that onboard camera. Gimball, it's fun, it's friendly, but how up in your face do you want a drone, even if it could save your life? Speak up and share your opinion in the comments. Click subscribe so you don't miss the next episode.